I showed off what I wanted to look like at the end in the last video, which you can go check out if you want to see what it's supposed to look like or what it's going to look like. For now, we're just doing the little outline, and then we will build it up more. I kind of just want to get the floor in first. It's not a very complicated shape going up, so it's not like it's gonna be too hard. I am going to grab some dirt, and I think I'm gonna start the outline over here. So, this is going to go out. So, 1, 2, 3. Is that right? Why do I feel like that's not right? I'll leave it. 1, 1, 2, 3. No, I really don't think that's right. Let me. this way. So so Here. also need to do the roof, which is not going to be easy at all. It's easy to build, but like, it's a lot of stuff is what I was trying to say. Not that it was easy to build. Okay, let me get this. Might even just be easier to just build like this. This might be easier. I'm doing it in a big line rather than I'm trying to do random sections. Honestly, really like the way that it looks without being stripped, but I much prefer it stripped. It's nice not stripped, but we're not leaving it like that. So how big does this thing really look like when we come up here? If I like came out of my house, I said I was gonna keep it up for June if I didn't like it. is gonna take so long. Let's get this line sheared. And I think we do need to come up with a new floor design for the LAs, for the place that they're gonna be in. Originally, it was Phantoms that were going into it. I've just realized this grass breaking is very loud. Okay, give me a second. I forgot that it's loud. I've just been talking the entire time. Originally, the place where we're gonna put the LAs was gonna be Phantoms. So it had like a kind of spooky floor theme with some blackstone, cobbled blackstone, I think, and gilded blackstone, which looked really cool in my opinion, but does not fit the theme of an LA. So I'm not sure what floor to give them. I don't even know, like, what is an LA? What's the lore in Minecraft? Is it Legends? The game that they came in. Like, what's the lore? What do they do? Where are they from? Because I don't. Because in Minecraft, you just get them in villager outposts, but that's not their home. They've been kidnapped and are being kept there. Oh my god. Are LAs and Vexes the same thing? Do they kidnap LAs to turn them into Vexes? Because when they added LAs, they updated the Vex texture. Not texture, the Vex model to be the same as the LA. I could be way off right there, but I genuinely had not stopped to think about it. Why else would they take them? But it's not the pillagers that make the LAs, though. It's the Evoker, I think. Not the LAs, the Vexes. It's the Evoker, right? But I guess pillagers could be. They probably all work together. Well, actually, they do all work together, because when you spawn a raid, the pillagers come with the things from the mansion. So they do all work together. That's honestly really cool lore, I think. That everything from the mansion plus witches and pillagers all work together. That's really cool. Am I onto anything about the LAs to the Vexes? I really had not stopped to think about that at all, but now I'm like, that would be really cool lore. Why else would they take them? I'm gonna have to look it up now. I really love Minecraft lore because it doesn't, like, nothing has to be right. I could be way off, and that's fine, because in my Minecraft world, it can be true. But it's also, like, it's so interesting. It's, I think somebody said, actually, give me a second, let me break this dirt first. Somebody said they love the way that Minecraft feels like a world healing. Like, everything, instead of, coral deteriorating and losing animals and stuff like that, we're gaining more and more things. Obviously, because it's a video game, that's how video games work, but, like, it feels like a world that's healing from, a destructive species, right? It's like, if there were humans everywhere, we destroyed the world, and now the world is healing, because there's no humans left except a player. Because, you know, we got coral reefs. We went from having no coral to them being there. We got stuff like that, right? Like, lush caves started popping up. Stuff like that is so cool. Just thinking about, like, the idea that the world is slowly healing itself. Okay, now on to the easier bit, I think, because I can actually place these. I'm just gonna break all of this glass and the grass. This is, like, really irritating that it does that to me. There we go. Yeah, I love the way that the world does. It really does feel like a world healing from almost, dying, I guess, because it didn't actually die. It almost died. But it survived, and now it's healing itself. Which doesn't really make sense evolution-wise, because, you know, everything just kind of popped up into existence, but I don't care. It's so cool. it was, what was it? There was one storm. Then there was no storm the next day. Then there was a storm every day for 4 days. So in 6 days, there were 5 storms, 4 in a row. And each one was so, so bad, like it shook the entire house. And I was home alone for all of them. It's kind of horrifying. Even the dogs were scared, so they didn't really help. It was more cool than anything, but it was still pretty scary, to feel the whole house shake, especially when you're surrounded by trees. Like, the wind could just blow extra hair in, and one could fall over onto the house. Like, what do I do then? But nothing bad happened, but it was still interesting. There was one bit where, there was no rain, there was just thunder and lightning, and then the thunder hit right as the rain started, but it was like, you know when you throw a bucket of water on the floor and it like hits the floor so hard it makes a really loud noise? It was like that. It went from no rain at all to 1,000 in like a second. Like literally, thunder happened, and right when it started, it was like someone threw a bucket of water on the planet. It was really, really cool. One of the coolest things I've like ever seen, honestly. But still pretty, pretty scary. To have to experience that by myself. Okay, I'm gonna have to get rid of this tree. It's getting in the way. Storms are honestly more fun for me, as long as somebody else is in the house. I find them more fun than scary. If the power goes out, then it's not fun anymore, but ironically, the power went out once, but it was the day after the last storm happened. So, like, I don't even know if it had anything to do with the storms. It kind of just, like, I woke up and there was no power, and I was like, okay. Or I didn't even wake up and there was no power. I was awake when it happened. I had just woken up, it was on my phone, and then all of a sudden everything went out. It's like, what the hell? There's no storm happening. Did that just like happen out of nowhere? I'm thinking maybe a tree like was starting to break because of the storm, and then fully broke in the morning and like knocked over a power line or something. I have no idea. It was fixed in a couple hours, so probably not something very extreme, but it was weird and awful. Because I also, for some reason that night, was like, no, I'm not going to charge my phone, I can't be bothered to reach the plug. So I woke up with my battery at 8%, like panicking, having to call my parents, like, how the hell do I turn the power back on? And then what? And then we realized it was not something that was happening in the house, it was because of the storms, probably. I did cover a big hole with grass. There's probably monsters spawning down there. That makes sense. It's like, why? What do you mean there's monsters nearby? No, there isn't. There very much is. That's my fault. Yeah, this is much easier than the other way that we were doing things. It's not the most annoying thing ever. It's a bit annoying, but it saves me having to go back up every time, and it means that I can just straight away do this. I do think we're coming to the end of the grass bit that I made, though. Yeah, I mean, we've got a little bit left, and then we can just go up and strip it all. Like, how many withers? I started to put in the museum. So, a lot. Three. What's that? Nine. Nine wither skulls. God, that's gonna be painful. I do have really good looting. Looting three. Which I think is the best looting you can get. So, I mean, should be fine. Hopefully we'll be fine. I would very much like it to be fine, because I don't want to spend ages getting stuff for Wither. I can't believe, I don't think I've ever beaten the Wither in Minecraft. I haven't done a lot of stuff in Minecraft, if I'm being honest. I just tend to build or like start a new world and then leave it after a while, or play in hardcore and then end up dying, right? Like, I don't really play Minecraft, I guess, the intended way. There is no intended way to play Minecraft. It's a sandbox game. You can do whatever you want, but like, I did not play to defeat the bosses. I've defeated the Ender Dragon in this world, and that's the one and only time I've defeated the Ender Dragon without cheats. I have beaten it after spawning stuff in creative before, just to say I did it, right? Just to experience fighting it, but I had never done it, like, legitimate. But now I have. Honestly, still one of my favorite videos that I've ever done. It was a lot of fun. It really was. I ended up dying really in this really stupid way. Twice. The first time was definitely my fault. I just blew myself up with a bed and lost everything. And then the second time, I got hit up by the dragon and ended up losing the rest of the stuff that I had. I ended up killing the dragon with a piece of bread, punching it to death, because it was literally, like, after my mistakes was, like, a hit away, so I had to. It was very fun, though. That's why we have a piece of bread in our house. It's not actually the bread that killed the Ender Dragon, I'm pretty sure I ate that. But it's fun to pretend. Same with the Elytra. I have an Elytra up there that's like labeled the first Elytra. It's not. I'm wearing the first Elytra. But, I mean, there's no point in nitpicking. It's the thought that counts, I guess. Okay, let me finish this. We are absolutely gonna need more dark oak wood, which sucks, but I don't think we're gonna need much more, which is nice. A little more, but like, probably a couple stacks, depending on how big the roof is. I don't really remember. Pretty sure it's like very big. Okay, now the annoying bit. I'm gonna have to go to the end as well and get my levels up, not my levels, get the stuff repaired, because our ladder is about to break, and so is our axe, and they're both very good. My axe especially, I do not want to lose that. Okay, so we have this whole section. It does bother me that it's not fully four tiles everywhere, right? Like, along the edge of that wall there, it's one instead of four, like here. You see what I mean? I don't like that, but I'm not fixing it. I think that the windows are good. You can barely tell the floor is off. So I'm not fixing it. I really do like that I went for the four tiles instead of the, like, one, I guess. Like, doing it in four blocks per tile rather than the other way I was gonna do it, because I feel like it's such a big thing. It works a lot better on, like, a grander scale, I guess. It looks nicer, being this big, in my opinion, anyway. I think it looks nicer. This is gonna look so cool. We should probably put the glass in as well, that we're gonna finish the... Okay, give me a second. I'm gonna break all this grass and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I think we'll get the floor done today if we have enough dirt. Okay, if we don't, then probably not. So probably the floor and the windows also, I think, they're not gonna be very hard. And I'm pretty sure I have a lot of glass on me somewhere. Or just sand. Because I don't want to have to smelt it, because then we are not getting the floors or the windows done. Okay, so like that, and then start doing this again. Yeah, hopefully we'll have enough air out from the stuff in our inventory for, I don't think we're going to have enough, 20 stacks really. Four glass was just a random lag spike. I don't understand the way the Minecraft works sometimes. Okay, there we go. That Enderman is going crazy. He's going on an adventure.